On 29th of May, 1999, the military government handed over power to an elected civilian president, Chief Olusegun Obasanjo.
I, Olusegun Obasanjo,
Do solemnly swear
That I will be faithful
And bear true allegiance
to the Federal Republic of Nigeria.
Some respondents said electoral reforms and politics require improvement to reflect the will of the people, pointing out that governance has a great distance to cover in addressing the challenges of economic inequality and social injustice. According to the respondents, Nigeria has a lot to do in terms of practicing true democracy. The respondents called for an overhaul of the democratic process, stressing that welfare and security should be the paramount responsibility of governments.
In a democracy, we experience police brutality. In a democracy, there's a surge of rape and armed robbery and kidnapping. In a democracy, the government cannot guarantee our life and property. There's no dividends of democracy. It is not affecting us. I think we can do better. We've not really enjoyed anything. And we should also have to give women more role to play in this dispensation if democracy, is really here to stay.
In a country where majority of people provide their own water, provide their own light, in a country where security is a privilege, even though the constitution we have says that the welfare and security of the people shall be the primary purpose of government. Yet, everybody is on his own. Like they say, everybody for himself, only God for all of us.
Nigeria cannot boast of constant power supply. 21 years of democracy, we must have leaders that have the fear of God. Leaders that will subscribe to the ethics and the ethos of democracy in order to rescue our country from the state of economic quagmire.
The respondents expressed satisfaction with uninterrupted democracy despite the numerous challenges bedeviling the country. Sharon Ajayi reporting.